So we go back to this, the two things that we were quick. Yeah, I think these are open-ended. I just left them for you to think. The collective responsibility, in what way are these related to the collective responsibility or the collective whole? I wouldn't even say responsibility, I'll say to the collective whole. There was something that we were talking about, dissimilar entities complement each other. You know what was this particular situation? Marriage of all the four brothers. And then Tulsidas says, the brides turned around and looked at the respective grooms. And looking at the paraspara lucky sukucha, looking at the mutual compatibility, looking at the mutual beauty. You know, mutual there means between that particular bride and the groom, the particular groom. And there is a rider given by Tulsi there. You know what he says subsequently? You know what is this paraspara stuff? Rama was dark in complexion. Sita was fair. I believe the brides looked at their respective grooms and realized that the two of them had opposite complexions. And they were happy to have that because the two differences matched one another. Rama was dark, Sita was fair. Lakshmana was fair, Urmila was dark. Bharata was dark, Mandavi was fair. Shatrughna was fair, Shrutakirti was dark. And Tulsi says, this was the perfect match. One who's dark and one who's fair. Maybe there are lots of lessons there. I'm not here to tell you what exactly is the lesson. It's for people to learn. Opposite pairs attract, and I would go to that extent to say, like some, he was talking about what our forefathers have told, and she was saying, like, today we have lost all that and come to this stage. I don't think so. This land ever spoke about differences in complexion as a modality of differentiating or discriminating people until about 300, 400 years ago. This land never had that difference. All the difference came in, obvious reasons, in the last 300 to 400 years. Before that, there was no discrimination of the human being on account of complexion. And what better example would I have? They looked at the paraspara lucky and then smiled at that. They were so happy because the man, the fair girl was so happy because the man was dark. That gave them joy, inner joy. He goes on to narrate the system. He says it gave them inner joy. The inner joy is not merely something physical alone. You know, he wanted to say something about the balance, dissimilar components making a whole. And coming to this I told you as, you know, we don't find it in most of the regular Ramayanic versions that we have. This is found in one of the northern recensions of Valmiki Ramayana. This again, can somebody tell me what this means? You know, we've all been looking at Ramayana as a story. And then I can just give a very mundane interpretation for this from the Pauranika point of view. I can say Ravana had a kind of boon that he will not be killed by anybody other than human beings or monkeys. So Rama said, don't change. Come as monkeys, only then he can be killed. Like, you know, all that is the Pauranika stuff. I would like to go a little away, outgrow that Pauranika stuff and come to some other level. Please remember, there are two names in Ramayana, two similar sounding names. One name in Lanka. Who would you remember in Lanka? Ravana's name, original name or so-called original name. Ravana is a name that came to him later. The word Ravana means somebody who's crying all the time. With 20 eyes, he was crying. If you cry with 2 eyes, you know, it's just crying, weeping. But then 20 eyes, so much of tears pouring out. He's supposed to have got that name from Shiva, Lord Shiva, when he tried lifting the Kailash, and then he was pushed down, and he started, because of the pain, he started crying. Yepodum Alubavan, that is Ravana. But then his original name, according to Ramayana, you know, in the initial phases of Ramayana, you find his name is Dashagriva, one who has 10 necks. Dashagriva, because 10 heads, he has 10 necks. Patthalayan is what is important. And then this side, you have somebody with Dasha, again, Dasharatha. Now please tell me, why do you want a monster character like that? How were the 10 heads of Ravana? This way, that way, this way, straight? Can you picturize? Difficult. Except that some of the bomb manufacturers can picturize. You know, for 10 heads, you have a large bomb bottle which can be suitable for all the 10 heads. The 10 heads there, the reason why people have been saying about 10 heads, and believe me, there are any number of Ramayana variations in this land. None of the variations have tried changing Ravana from his 10 heads. All Ravanas have 10 heads. The reason, it is only a symbolic idea of the overgrowth of the 10 Indriyas of man. The egotistical growth. You know, when you look at a person with lots of ahankara, what do you say? Manda pirthama. Manda gano. This is only to show the mandaganam. If you ask a child to draw, you know, it's very visual. So this is a kind of a visual symbolism to say somebody who had ahankara at its best. And here you have another person, Dasharatha. What does it mean? Patthu chariot. You mean to say, you know, the normal Pauranika version is he controlled 10 chariots in the war field. It only means the person who is able to control the 10 Indriyas. Somebody who can control the 10 Indriyas, to him godliness descends. Somebody who is not able to control the 10 Indriyas becomes a Rakshasa. That is the basic symbolism that runs in Ramayana. And coming to this, Rama says, you all remain monkeys. You're going to the war front, you all remain monkeys. But then when they come to Ayodhya, all of them transform. Is it that people in Ayodhya could not witness monkeys? They could not behold monkeys? You know, it's a kind of a little tricky. It's not so. Until the time of that fight, it is that monkey attitude. The moment, yes, Ramarajya, he says, when you're coming towards Ramarajya, control that monkey attitude. Control your senses. Control all that is redundant. Prune off. Become the organized human being. And that is Ramarajya. That march by the Vanaras, march by the human beings, I only look at it, Rama was asking for the march of the human society towards Ramarajya. And that's what we have been trying to do all the while. Thank you.